saw you standing there. About fell out my chair. And when you moved your mouth to speak, I felt the blood go to my feet. Now it took time for me to know what you tried so not to show. Something in my soul just cried. I see the want in your blue eyes. Baby, I'd love you to want me the way that I want.
This is, of course, I Love You to Want Me, from the early 70s. I even think it was from 72, so that makes the song as old as I am. It's my birth year. However, I've always known it, but never thought of playing it, until recently I bumped into a recording by him from maybe a year ago, so pretty recent, just him playing it on guitar and singing it, so that also always gives me a good look at how he would do it acoustically. Indeed, skipping the little solo, even though he would show how he plays it. He doesn't necessarily get into it too much, but just, you know, you can actually see it. Figure it out yourself if you want to. However, in this lesson, I break it indeed down as teachers usually do. When to play something, what to play, and fingerings and stuff like that. However, the song is, regardless of the little solo, is perfect for beginners, both the right hand, I mean the left hand and the right hand, because for the chords, only four of those, and I would want to say easy chords, but when you're a beginner, nothing is easy. But however, those are chords which appear in many songs. So a G major, like so, to A minor, to C, to D. I've also seen him play C with a low G there in the bass. However, I actually don't talk about it in the lesson I recall now. However, you could if you want to. So those four chords. I show you, of course, how to finger those. I would break it down as if you're a total beginner. If you don't need it, just skip the segment there. How to move your fingers efficiently and such. Anyway, so that's one thing, of course. Then the strumming. What I really like about it is that he actually starts with single downstrokes. So actually playing what we would call at the speed of eights. So just quarter notes on the downstroke. So one, two, three, four. When my hand comes up, those are the ends of the beats. One and two and three and four and one and so on. And at one point, when he's done with the first verse, he changes it to double time, so the speed of 16. So the motions of my hand are now turning into downstroke, like so. But let me do this again. One and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and one and two. I'm not necessarily playing the ends of the beats, the upstrokes, but my hand is moving that way. And you should do the same. It really should look like this. And then to double time. And one and two and three and four and one and two and three and four. And once you get the hang of that, then you can, you know, play it a little bit more, interesting, I would say. So like one and two. This is how he kind of does it. Just a down, 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 down. So you go, that's what I would do, from the lower strings to the middle strings, and then you have an occasional upstroke. So one and two and up. That's how you call out about an upstroke in double time. And then you do exactly the same thing for beats 3 and 4. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. 2 and 4 are important. That's where the snare of the drum comes in. So you want to go to the middle strings there a little. Play it a tad stronger so you can copy the snare of the drum. So 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. Though I personally like for the choruses, because the snare comes in actually on every beat, like 1, 2, 3, 4. So for that I like to 1, 2, 3, 4 and 1, 2, 3, 4 and 1, 2 and so on. So down, 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 down. So those are your options. Don't get me wrong, I show you, you know, I break down a starting point, but of course there is room for variation. Same goes actually for those chords. I showed you those four. What he does is like embellish them a little by, for example, taking off his middle finger there in the bass. So going to a, well, whatever. And then for A minor, taking off his index and putting it back down. And for C, same thing, but now indeed your middle finger. And no, I'm not thinking in particular for D. Just to dress it up here and there, I show you that, of course, as well, on which beats you can do that, on which beats it works well, and things that he does, and so on. Okay, what else? There, yes, he does show the little solo, which actually appears here on the 5th and 7th frets, relative to the capo. Keep that in mind. So what is it? Yes, I break it down in the lesson. Let's not. I should stop this. One thing I will tell you: when to play the little solo. When does it come in? Well, it comes in on beat 4, 4 and 1. There. So you finish actually the chorus with G, beats 3 and 4. That is, and then on the 4th beat, there you play. You start playing. So it has a couple of pickup notes, and this is beat 1. Same actually goes for the beginning of the song. That's a pickup measure as well. And now you have the actual first measure of the song. Okay, I'm already talking indeed too much. If someone says you're talking too much, it's true. But if you listen carefully, then you can take away a lot of this little preview already, and maybe you don't even need a lesson then. Okay, but if you do want to have more details, because there are, I have written out tablature for the strumming and also for the little solo, and of course the whole song and progression and all the usual suspects. So I would say check it out, because then you really have a breakdown of everything you need to know to play this song. Again, if you're a beginner, get it. If you're not a beginner, just play it. It's a great song. It is now at totallyguitars.com. Check it out over there.